Good evening, one and all. Can you hear me? Okay, fine. Thank you. Thanks for your confirmation. Okay, now the time is 4:13. We'll start in 2 minutes, okay? Very good evening, very good evening. Okay, anyway, we have only 1 minute. So meanwhile, we will discuss the yesterday's assignment. So I have given a very easy question to you, all of you, because yesterday I already told some examples programs regarding palindrome and reversing the given number, right? So in the same way, I'm asking the reversing of the string, okay? So here, this logic is already there in the palindrome program, right? So you just copy that code, that's all. Instead of if condition, you just write a single line here, that's all. So I asked that question only, but even though I'm given only that question, many students are not doing. I think some students only submitted the assignment. So I don't know. So anyway, let me take an example here. So I'm just giving an x equal to input enter any string, that is anything but old string, and w for in x. That means, for example, if I'm taking like any string, let me take an example like I will take like Python, okay? So I'm getting NOHTYP. So this is the string. You can give in spaces also, that's not an issue at all. And please wait this. I will take the annotations. Okay, so here I enter any string means I have taken Python. That means you can check here the first character will be placed in. For I in x in means this is only dummy string. That means so whenever you are finding the reverse of a name, reverse of a string, given string, you have to store particular string in a variable, right? So that's the reason I'm taking a w only. Okay, so for I in x, that means the first character p will be stored in I. Okay, so the first character p will be stored in I, because for I in x means so for loop can be accessed in with range of values, and you can give list and you can also give the string also, as we already discussed in the for loop, right? So according to that rule, okay, according to that rule, so with the first name, the first character p will be moved to the I. So then w equal to I plus w. That means w contains nothing, no elements are there, but it is a string actually. That means is now I plus w means the p will be added to the particular w. That means in output, it will save like I plus W. Here I am declaring not W plus I. You should understand carefully. So there is a basic difference between W plus I and I plus W. Okay. So here I am going like I plus W means, for example, I am declaring like empty with P. That means now W contains P only. Now W contains P only. Okay. So reverse for but here the for loop will be executed and. Next, you can move to the next character, that is called y. Okay, that is called y. So that means I will be stored the value y. So now w equal to I plus w. Now what is the value of y? That means y plus p. Y plus p means y will be added to p, right? That means the y will be stored like yp. Okay. So in the same way, you will get the same. Okay, so then yp, then you can take the another value like t. Okay, so you can take the value like t. That means the for loop will be iterated automatically to the new character. Okay, so then here w contains yp now. So here w contains yp now. Then I plus w means now I takes the t character. Okay, so because first two characters are completed, it will take t. That means t plus yp, that means typ. That means the last three characters like this. Okay, in that way it will added all the characters. So this is the just this is the basic example. And some so many students are raised in a different way. That's not an issue. But I will tell you one thing, guys. Because whenever you are writing any program, in interview point of view or any external examination, don't use the predefined functions. Okay, if it is mentioned by using it, predefined functions also, you can write, no problem. But some students written like using length function and all. Okay, so many functions are used in the program. But try to don't use in a special interview point of view and also in external examination also. And according to question, you can do, no problem. Okay, so and I like one more question. I think this is submitted by I think T Jyoti from EEE department. And let me clear all the drawings. And one of the student has submitted like this. Okay, you can see here. So n equal to len. So you know that string can be accessed from right to left also. So he used that concept actually. So n equal to length of s. Anyway, he used the length function, but that's not wrong. But I'm telling in a different way. Okay, because some may think like they are using built-in functions. They may think like that, and especially interview point of view. That's the reason why I'm telling. It's not wrong at all. Okay, so I less than or equal to n. You know, whenever I'm giving like a string, like for example, let me give you an example. So if I'm giving like, so you know already, I'm giving k u m a r. For example, I am giving a string here. Okay, so it can be accessed from left to right and also right to left. This is called forward indexing, and this is called negative indexing. That is backward indexing. It is possible only in Python. So that means if you would like to print the minus one position, you will get the r first. If you would like to print the s of minus two, that is nothing but a will be printed. So in that way also you can think. So one student submitted like this. I think many students also submitted, but I like this way. That's the reason only I'm telling. S of minus I. He just taken the value length. He just I less than equal to n and minus I. He is printing s of minus I. That means s of minus I means it is, he is printing the last character. So that is also fine. Okay. So anyway. He is also I think CSE student. Okay, 18553. Okay, fine. So this is up to yesterday's class, and many students are asking that they are having the classwork from 4:15 and 4:30 also. So you know guys, I'm also busy with some exams. So that's the reason only I'm taking the class from 4:15 to 5:15. I got some students complaint like from finally EEE and also. Secondly, EC students are asking me, so please change the time. But I can't, because up to 6:30 I have to be here in the college itself. That's the reason why I'm taking in this way. So anyway, I will post the YouTube link. You can go through that. Okay. So thank you guys, and let me move to the today's topics. And I have covered almost four questions, four important programs in the last class. So let me move to the remaining programs also. Then we will move to the our syllabus topics. Okay, so and you know, in the last class I have ended with the factor of a number. So basically, whenever you use it to find out the factor of a number, so you should take one loop must be there, because we have already one factorial function is also there. I think you know already, right? It's a predefined function. So for example, if I would like to find out the factor of a given number. We have so many options, right? We have so many options. For example, which function is there? Anyone knows? I have already told in the last classes. Which function is there for find out the factorial? What is the shortcut? Yes, yeah, the name implies. So very good, very good. No factor, the complete matrix. So no, Kanna, it's not factor. I have already discussed the previous function, right? Factorial only. If you would like to find out the factor of a number, for example, let me give an example. I'm giving number, or what? No, nothing. Number is also not required actually. So let me give a print directly. Print of factorial. Okay, but it will not execute, right? I'm giving factor of 5, right? So what I have to do? It is getting error. What I have to do? Please tell me. What I have to do? Why it is getting error? Yeah, very good, very good. Import math, very good guys, very good, very happy, very happy. So import math, I think you understand all the concepts, right? Thank you, God. So import, 1 minute, guys. Import, 1 minute. Math, and I have to add one more line, right? Here I have to give math dot. So let me execute it. So what, Mandy? So but don't do like this one, especially in entry point of view or examination point of view. Okay. So you it may be used whenever you need to. For example, if you would like to find out the sine series. Okay. So there is a big formulas are there in mathematics, like sine series, next cosine series. We have like 1 minus x square by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial plus minus x power 4 by 4 factorial. We have some series, right? So in that case, you can use directly in the denominator. You need to calculate factorial every time. In that program, you can use directly these functions. So that's, you can use like that only. But whenever you are asking in any interviews, you will display like this. They will not get. You will not get any impression. Okay. Anyway, you should write in both ways. That's better. Okay. We have one function is there, sir. That is in the math dot module. That means whenever you are inputting math dot factorial of 5, then we will get the factorial of 5. So what I have to do first of all? Let me write a program. First, you have to understand. You know that formula. Whenever you're using like 3 factorial, I'm just writing here 3 factorial. So 3 factorial, actually this symbol is a not operator in C in programming, so we cannot use this, but in mathematically you can use like 3 factorial. So 3 factorial means 3 into 2 into 1, that is 6 only. Okay, in the same way 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, so that is nothing but 120. So you will get like this. But whenever you are thinking about how we have to write the program, you just take one variable first, because you have to multiply with one, right? So you can take like f equal to 1 or anything like that. Okay, so not only f, you can take any variable. Not I'm just taking like f because of factorial program. I'm taking f value. So if I'm giving a 5, it will be executed up to 5. That means you have to give the condition in the for loop. Okay. That means up to which position? That means if you would like to start from 1, because 1 is the major, 1 or also 0, because 0 factorial also 1, right? So we have, and some students don't know about 0 factorial is 0. No, 0 factorial is 1 only, and 1 factorial is also 1 only. So 2 factorial means 2 only. So you know already formula side. So just by using for loop, and you can iterate the, that means you can iterate the for loop with I value. And you can just multiply f value with I. That's all. This is the only logic actually. So let me write it, and I will complete it, introduce, and will completely explain each and every line. Okay. So this is the only logic. This is the two lines. You no need to remember actually. Just I will copy everything. I added some comment lines also for understanding purpose only. So you can remove. That's not an issue at all. Anyone, yesterday I told about how to trace a program by using debug. Anyone tried in your spider window? Please mention in the chat box. I want to know. Anyone tried? Yes. Okay. I got it from one student. Very good. Okay. Second student. Please do, guys. Please. Because whenever you're using tracing, okay, that means you can easily understand the program. Okay, but if you know tracing, then very good, very good. I got only 5 answers. Sharwani, Satya, Naveen, Saranya, and okay, fine. Yes. Okay, I think almost 10 students, and that's all. I tried, sir. Okay, thank you. Fine, but definitely you should do. Okay, because whenever you are uncomfortable with any program, if you are not able to find out the tracing, you can trace the program. You no need to take the help of anyone like me. Okay, you no need to take the help. Anyway, if you ask me, definitely I will help you. That's not a problem at all. But I'm telling. Okay, so let me remove the comment lines, because if you are thinking these comment lines means the program looks more lines. So that's the reason I'm just removing. For understanding purpose, I will here. Okay, so let me run it first, and I will explain. But don't by heart the program. I will tell the how to. Easy, how to find out the logic easily. Okay, I will tell you. I'm just giving 5 factorial of 5. factor of the number 5 is 120. I'm getting factor of the number 5 is 120. So anyway, let me explain the program. But I don't want to do up to 5 factorial because we have a lot of programs to complete. Before going to that, I would like to share this feedback link because sometimes may power failure, okay? So let me share it. So please don't do now. Just copy the link. Okay, so just copy the link. Okay, so listen guys. Here I have taken number. Why I am taking number equal to, you know it. Because whenever I would like to find out the factor of a number, that means you have to read only one value. This should not be remember actually, okay? For example, I would like to find out the biggest number between two numbers. Then you have to take two values. That means A and B are number one and number two. So in the same way you should think. So number equal to int of input of enter the number. I'm giving like this, okay? That means here you have to find out the factorial of a number. That means you have to take only one integer. So that's the reason I'm taking number equal to int of input of enter the number. Why I'm taking integer? Because you have to do with the program like integers only, right? So that's the reason only I'm taking like this. So that means, for example, let me execute it 4 factorial or 3 factorial. So we can trace easily and we will get the output. So because I don't want to waste the time. So we have to cover a lot of programs. Okay, if you have doubts, you can ask me in the chat box. Definitely I will explain them. That's not an issue at all. So for better understanding and to move fast, I'm taking only 4. That's all. Okay, so now I'm taking 4 means that value here, the 4 will be stored in num variable. That means num equal to, now it contains 4. So f equal to 1. Just now I told f equal to 1. Why I am taking f value as 1? So is it necessary, sir? Yes, it is necessary. Because, so here I am using a one function, that is this one operation like f equal to f into I. So if any number is multiplied to 0, it will give 0. If any number which will multiply it above 1, it will not change, right? So that's the reason only I am taking f equal to 1. So that means here f equal to 1 is nothing but, so it's a like a factorial. That means whatever the value you are storing, that means result storing. That means if you are finding the factorial of 4 is 24, that means f value is 24. Then f is like a output variable, okay? So here I am f equal f into I means I am taking f value as 1. Just note down, because whenever you are doing tracing, you just write a number equal to 4 and f equal to 1. It should be very important. For I in range of 1 comma num plus 1, why I am taking 1? Because, so you have to start the loop from 1 to, okay? I am giving number plus 1. Why I am giving number plus 1, I will tell you. Don't worry. So let me give clarity, guys. 1 comma number plus 1. Number is 4. That means 4 plus 1. That is 5. Okay? I will tell you guys. For I in range of 1 comma 4, I would like to print I. For I in range of 1 comma 5, I would like to print I. What values will be printed in the output screen? From 1 to or from 0 to, tell me in the chat box, please. I would like to know. Yes, very good. Saranya, that is absolutely right answer. 424, that is right answer. Once again, I am telling, if I am giving for I in range of 1 comma 5, then what values will be printed on the output screen? Yeah, very good, guys, very good. Everybody is telling correct answer. Thank you very much. So hope it is fine. So that's enough guys. Thank you guys. So that means why I am taking number plus 1, that means you know, because whenever you would like to find out the number from 4 factorial means 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. You need to calculate that way. Okay, but here whenever you are giving like 1 comma 4 means it will take from 1 to 3 only. But here you need to calculate up to 4. That's the reason I am adding number plus 1 here. Okay, so this is the way to think. Okay, because there is no increment and decrement operators in this Python. So that's the reason only I am taking like this. Okay, so for I in range of 1 comma 5. So now I contains, let me write here. For I contains, just now you told that 1 to 4. No, but the first value should be I value 1. It will enter into this loop. That means these two lines are only the logic. That's all. You no need to remember and you no need to by heart. It's very easy logic, right? F equal F into I. So then you should calculate F equal to. I already written like F equal F into I. That means 1 into 1. 1 into 1 is nothing but 1. That is already completed. Whenever F value is completed, again it will go back to the for loop. And I value incremented to 2. That means 1 will be removed and I value will be incremented to 2. Because 1 comma 5 means 1 is eliminated, then it will come to the second iteration. Now 2 means f equal to f into I. F is there in one value, and 1 into I means 1 into 2. That is 1 into 2 is nothing but f value is 2 now. That means again second iteration f equal to f into I means f value will be 2 now. And after that I value will be incremented to 3. That means now 2 is removed, I value incremented to 3. So now I value is 3 now. Now I will calculate f equal to f into I. That means f equal to f into I means f value is 2, I value is 3. 2 into 3. So 2 into 3 is nothing but 6. Okay, so then again it will increment to the I value 4. It will stop after the 4. You know that because you already told that 1 to 5 means I value will be executed from 1 to 4, right? So that's the reason I value is 4. This is the last iteration in the program. So f equal to f into I. That means f value is 6 into I. What is I value here? 4. 6 into 4. So 6 into 4 is nothing but 24. So here I am getting 24. But after that I value will be incremented 5, but it will not get into the loop because 1, 5 means it will iterate up to 4 only. So then loop will skip. That means for f equal f into I, this line will not be printed. Then it will go to the print line. Factorial of the number percentage d is percentage d. I am giving percentage num comma f. That means in the f, the result is stored like 24. I am just giving percentage for understanding like that. These are the various formatting output. This is the concept related to our syllabus. They mention like format like that. Okay, you can different ways to represent that concept actually. You can use format method. You can use percentage also to format the output. You can if you know the concept, you can explain easily, right? So I am just giving factorial of. Let me 1 minute. I will move this. Okay, so I am giving the percentage num comma f. That means the first num value is stored here and f value is stored here. That means the factorial of 4 is 24 is displayed like that. Okay, so this is the program's tracing. I hope you understand, guys. So here you can easily understand the logic. I am just giving 1. Now I will tell you guys why I am giving from 1. If I am giving like 0, the number will be 0 and f always stores like 0. Okay. That means once f it is 0, then whenever you are doing multiplication, it obviously will be 0, right? So that's the reason you cannot take the first value as 0. In that way, you have to think. How would I know how to write this program? Means you should think once, because this is not a single line or the single English concepts to understand easily. This is programming. You have to understand the logic, how to write a program. Okay. So for I in range, that means I have to start from 1. And I have to read from up to number plus 1. That's all. This is the logic only. And f equal f into I. So fi by default I am taking n1, because any number multiplied by 1 will give the same result. That's the reason only I am taking f equal to f into I. And you can also write that line by using shorthand notation f star equal to I. You can also shortcut this line. F star equal to I means f equal to f into I. Okay. That is also fine. So this is the factorial of a program. And try to write this way. If you are asking an interview, so if you are attending any interview, so you can write the both lines and you can explain. This is also one of the way. This function is not there in either C language or CPP or Java, whatever it may be. Okay, in Python only we are having lakhs of function, not only single. Many students know that compared to C language, Java having highest library functions. But no boss, I will tell you clearly, compared to C and Java, there are n number of functions are there in Python. For taking a screenshot of a particular image of any background computer, okay, you just need a 5 lines of code in Python. There are a lot of libraries, not only that concept actually I'm telling. Okay, so you can do a lot of programs by using that libraries. Okay, so that's the reason math is also one of the library module actually. So you can provide the functions dot factorial like that. Okay. So let me move to the next concept. If you are having any doubts in this program, you can mention in the chat box. Otherwise, I will move to the next concept. And I am telling only one output for every program. And let me move to the next question. Program to check whether the given number is Armstrong number or not. First, let me check how to write a program. Before I am copying the code, let me explain what is the logic and all. That's the reason. Because whenever I'm using copy and paste here, you know, don't understand better way. So that's the reason I would like to tell in an easy way. Let me take one variable called. First of all, you have to understand what is the Armstrong number. And everybody knows what it meant by Armstrong number. I'm just taking a variable number is called 153. Okay. So first, let me explain what is the Armstrong number. So the number the number, then sum of cubes. That means if you perform the sum of cubes of that number, you will get the same number. Then that number is called as a Armstrong number. That's all. First you have to understand the definition. Then only you can write the logic. So yesterday I told about the reverse of a given number. By using of a reverse of a given number, you can easily find out the I think some other example I told, palindrome, right? Palindrome. So that means there is only two lines difference. I am just adding if condition and else condition. That's all. There is no much difference. In the same way, I am also using in this way because you already know how to retrieve the last digit. Okay. If any number modulus, what number I have to give to get the remainder? Please tell me in the chat box, guys. Some student is asking. 1 minute. Okay. Yes, very good. Thank you. Thank you. So thanks for your response, Anna. And sum of individual number is equal to the number. Very good. Okay, that's fine. Next, sir, in reverse of a number, we store number value in number. In that time, number and number are the same memory location. We change the number value. Number value is changed or not? No, it cannot change. I will also today explain, Likita. So you are asking a good doubt actually. Why I am taking number equal to num means? So whenever the number is sent to zero, that means number, if you are given, if you are using a fluid division operation, the number will be to the zero position. So actually, Likita is asking some doubt. So I think Likita means your sister wrote a MCET exam in the last 2 days back, right? So I think I discussed some points with your father also. Yes. Yes, Likita, good question. And your father interacted me 2 days back. You are already listening the Python classes. I think you are from third CSE, right? So anyway, your doubt is a very good doubt. Some students may got the doubts like that. So that means, for example, if you are giving like a num equal to number, number value will be stored in num, but there is no effect in number because that's the reason I am taking a dummy variable. So I think this program also will take the dummy variable. I think so. 1 minute, let me check. Yeah, okay, anyway, that's fine. Here also I am taking a dummy variable because this is actually I would like to find out the Armstrong number, right? So I have to here also number will be moved to zero. So you can understand easily. I think you hope you understand today concepts, Likita. Don't worry. So your doubt will be clear today. Don't worry. So let me explain, guys, what is the Armstrong number. So I think many of the students have mentioned in the chat box, if you number modulus 10, it will give the last digit, right? That means, for example, 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. So let me take 1 cube is 1, 5 cube is 125. Okay, 5 cube is 125, 3 cube is 27. Okay, 3 cube is 27. So let me add these two numbers, you will get 153 again. I think, hope you know what is an Armstrong number now. That means, if you are taking one number, if you have sum of cubes of that particular number, you will get the same number. Okay, then that number is called as a Armstrong number. And if you're taking like, I'm taking like 100, if I'm taking like 100, 1 cube plus 0 cube plus 0 cube, okay, 1 cube plus 0 cube plus 0 cube, it will give 1 only. That means it is not at all equal to 1, 100 is not at all equal to 1. This is not a Armstrong number. That's all. It is very easy example, guys, okay. So not only 153, we have a lot of numbers. If you would like to find out, if I'm telling what is an Armstrong number, if you would like to find out the what are the various Armstrong numbers are there from 1 to 500, you can use loops, that's all. Just I will tell one concept, you can use the loops, you can retrieve the 1 to 500, you can access, for example, if I am telling what is even number or what is odd number, you will write a logic like if I modulus 2 equal to 0, it is even number, else it is an odd number. That's a very easy logic because we have mind, right? So it's a very easy example. But if I am asking that, if you would like to print 1 to 50 numbers, that means in between 150 numbers, I would like to print even numbers, means then you have to add one for loop for that particular program. That means if I modulus 2 equal to 0, before that you have to add like for I equal to 1, I less than or equal to 50, I plus plus in the C language. But in Python, you just for I in range of I comma, that means you have to give the last value, like that means you can retrieve the same value, that means upper limit or lower limit, you can take two values. So you can do in that way, okay? So hope you understand, guys. Let me explain now. First, so you can do, so a lot of numbers like 3, 7, so Armstrong numbers. You can find, no problem. 7 cube is 343, 3 cube is 27, 1 cube is 1. So you can add 371, you will get the 371, okay? So 371 is Armstrong number. Okay, let me clear now. So before going to the explanation part, how we have to write a program. First, you have to take loop. That should be final because you have to retrieve each digit. You have to retrieve each digit. And that means here you have to do, you have to do modulus of 10 definitely because you have to retrieve the last digit. Okay. Then you should perform power. That means in C language and Java, you are using a power operator. But here nothing is required. You can have a operator in arithmetic operators. We have a power operator. What are the operators? Yes, very good. Very good, Priyanka. You are giving a very good answer. Sir, every single digit is option number or not. Okay. You can check in that way also. That's not an issue. Okay. Only three students have responded. What happened, guys? You forget about the arithmetic operators. What is the symbol for finding the power in Python? I am asking the operator, not function. Yes, double star. Yes, double star. Yes. Then that means if you are using like I am just giving a digit. I am just giving a digit or digit variable for number modulus 10. This is the first logic I have to write. So that means here now the digit contains 3. Then you have to perform 3q like that. That means D star 3. You have to do again with d value, right? That means d equal to d cube plus you have to like that logic. Okay, so here the first value 3 cube, and you, that means for example 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. But you can also done in programming, is it equal to 3 cube plus 5 cube plus 1 cube? Yes, it is also equal, right? I'm doing only addition operation. Whether you can perform plus 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube or 3 cube plus 5 cube plus 1 cube, the result may not change. So I will do in this way. Okay, so that means, for example, if I'm using modulus 10, so that means 3 will be with the last digit and you can perform the Q. Okay, now it will get some value, right? So then you should remove these 3. You should remove these 3. How you should remove 3? If you're giving like 153 floor division of 10, then 3 will be removed automatically. You will get 15 because 15 tens are 150. Okay, according to floor division, it will not give fractional values. Okay, so definitely you will get 15. That means you should definitely understand in programming, you should understand only the basic difference between division and modulus. If you are giving any number with modulus 10, you will get the last digit. Okay, if I am giving 2000, like for example, I am giving like 2, 3, 4, 5. Just it's a very easy example. If you are giving modulus 10, it will give last digit. If you are giving divided by 10, you will get first 3 digits. That's all. Okay. Again, if you are giving 234 modulus 10, it will give last digit. If you are giving 234 by 10, it will give 23. That's all. Okay, so it's nothing is there. You can easily remember the concept. Okay, so then I will move to the question: how to write a program. So this is the program. You definitely understand, don't worry. I'm giving 153. 153 is an Armstrong number. So I'm getting correct answer. And let me give 371. 371 is an Armstrong number. Let me give 100. 100 is not an Armstrong number. Okay? Hope you are clear, right? So let me move to the first value, 153. Okay. So let me explain, guys. Then you will understand. Yes, Ashwini, very good. That is also one of the option number. I would like to ask you actually, but anyway, you already responded. That's fine. Next, I will explain, guys. Definitely. So don't worry. How I am writing this logic. So first of all, I am taking like 153. Input of entering number. That means our number is 153. You should write in your notebook number equal to 153 like that. Okay. I'm doing tracing only. Next, sum equal to 0. Why I am doing sum? Because whenever you're giving digit cube, then you have to add to one variable, right? Because if you're using digit cube, then you have to store another variable. Like that's the reason I'm taking sum variable. So sum equal to 0. Temp equal to num. So according to Ligita, he's also asked one doubt. So what is the use of temp equal to num here? I will tell you guys. So here I am transferring the number value that is 153 to temp. So now temp contains 153. Once again I am telling. So many students got doubt, like whenever I am giving temp equal to num means they will write like what is temp, what is num, they will do like that. Don't do like that. So number is 153. That means whenever you are telling in programming, I mean, can assign it to A. You have to think in this way, because equal to operator is right to left associativity, not left to right. You should understand very carefully. Now number value will be stored in temp. That means temp is 153 now, because whenever you are doing divided by 10 under modulus 10, okay, whenever you are doing divided by 10 especially, our number will be truncated to 0, because how many iterations we have to perform. That means if the number is 0, then how you can compare with the whether it is Armstrong number or not. That means you have to store original number also, right? That's the reason I am taking number here, I am taking temp here. So I will tell anyway, that's not an issue. Temporary variable 153 greater than 0. So this is true. 153 is greater than 0. This is true, right? So now it will calculate digit equal to. I am just writing D equal to like that. Shortcutly, I am writing T equal to temp modulus 10. That means 153 modulus 10. I already told in the last class 153 modulus 10 means it will give 3 only, last digit value. Now sum equal to sum plus. Sum means initially I am taking 0. Okay. Sum equal to 0. 0 plus digit to the power of 3. You already told these are the two star operators. This is used to perform the power operations, right? So digit means digit contains 3. Our digit contains 3. 3 cube. 1 cube value, 3 cube value is 27. Now sum equal to 0 plus 27 means memory. Okay. Now temp equal to temp by. That means I'm writing in a shortcut way. Sum plus equal to means sum equal to sum plus. In the same way, temp divided by flow division equal to 10 means temp equal to temp flow division of 10. What is the value of temp? 153. 153 flow division of 10 means it will give 15. Just now I told you, if you are giving like divided by 10, it will give first two digits. If you are giving like modulus 10, it will give last digit. Okay. So why I am getting 153 by 10 equal to 15? 15 tens are 153. That's all. 15 tens are 150. The remainder is 3. But remainder, you can forget about the remainder, because here I already like 153 by 10 means 15 tens are 150. Okay, I am doing division operation only. I will get 15 only, because I am not getting into the remainder part. Remainder operator is percentage. I am using only flow division here. So whenever this line is executed, it will go back to the while loop again, because these three lines belongs to the while loop. This is called indentation. Now t greater than 0. Now t means 15 greater than 0, because digit equal to temp modulus 10. Temp is 15 now. 15 modulus 10, it will give 5. That means digit in the world, it is taking like 3. Now digit value is 5, because 15 modulus 10 is 5 only. Next, sum equal to sum plus digit to the power of 3. Okay, so sum equal to sum plus. Actually, sum contains S equal to 27 old value. That is 27 plus, okay, 27 plus digit to the power of 3. Okay, so let me write D value is 5. 5 star star 3. So okay, here you have to understand the concept like precedent and order, precedence and order of evolution, or precedence and associativity rule. So I have explained clearly, whenever you are using a plus operator and power operator, power operator is the highest precedence, so it will perform 5 cube first and then add it to 27. If you are doing like 27 plus 5, that means 32 to the power of 3. You may think like that, your program will be wrong. Okay, so you don't think like that first, because you know already in operator precedence, I have forwarded the notes, the highest priority should be brackets. After that, the second priority in Python are double star. Then only you are moving to the star or slash or modulus. Okay, you already know, right? And also power operator also right to left associativity. That means it will be executed first. That means 5 cube means 125. 125 plus 27, then it will give 152. Okay, so now sum contains 152. I will write here only. Now sum contains 152. Why I am taking sum equal to 0 initially, then you will know here. Okay, definitely. Then temp equal to temp floor of 10. Let me 1 minute, guys. So voice is breaking sometimes. Okay, fine. Let me switch off my video. Is it okay, guys? Now is it okay? Fine. Is my voice is clear, Sushma? Okay, fine. Thank you. Okay, fine. Thanks for your response. I will proceed. Next. So then, you know, some kind is 152. Temp equal to temp floor division of 10. That means 15 floor division of 10. 15 floor division of 10, that is nothing but 1. 1 tens are 10. So that is remainder is 5. So now temp contains 1. Again, it will check 1 greater than 0. Yes, 1 is greater than also 0. Now digit equal to 1 modulus 10. 1 modulus 10 value is, many students are doubt here, 1 only. Once again, I am telling 1 modulus 10 value is 1 only. Okay. So now it will get sum equal to sum plus digit cube. Sum contains 152. 152 plus 1 cube. 152 plus 1 cube, it will get sum value as 153. 152 plus 1 cube is nothing but 153. Okay. So then it will get temp equal to temp by 10. Temp value is 1. 1 divided by 10, it will return 0. Then it will check the condition again. 0 greater than 0. 0 greater than 0. Okay. 0 greater than 0, condition false. Then it will move to the if condition. Now you can check number value. What is the number? I have taken number value as 153 only. Okay. So Likita, you asked one doubt. If I'm using only number instead of temp, here in this case number will be 0. Then if you compare number with sum, you cannot get the Armstrong number. Okay. That means you should compare the value which is taken earlier. That means whenever you are taking input, you are storing the variable like num only. You should compare with num of the sum value. Sum equal to 153, num equal to 153. Both variables are 153. 153 equal to 153. 153 is an Armstrong number. You will get the output like this. Okay. So otherwise, if you are taking 100, you will get that number is not an Armstrong number. So this is the 1 minute. Let me check. No problem. Why do you multiply three? Sir, why multiple with 3? Okay, good question, Manasa. So let me write it here. So I already told, so that means this is the basic formula. So according to Armstrong number, I think some student is asking why you are giving only 3 here. Okay, I will tell you. The formula is 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. Then only you will get the Armstrong number. That means, for example, the formula itself, what is an Armstrong number, means sum of the cubes of the number, okay, that will get the same number is called an Armstrong number. Okay, that's the reason only I'm taking like this. Okay, so that's the reason only I'm taking like this cube. Okay, so I think Manasa, your doubt cleared. Okay, so let me run it again. Okay, so this is called num equal sum. Why I'm giving condition, hope everyone knows like this. If I'm giving like temp here, you will not get Armstrong number, right? So that's the reason only I'm cleaning this. 1 minute. So can you please tell me, Nagini, which is the four digit Armstrong number? Can you please tell me? Then I will execute. Or otherwise I will give any Armstrong number, not an Armstrong number. No. That means you have to. Oh no. So 1634. That means you are getting cubes also same number. No. Actually, your doubt is actually you should understand one thing. Armstrong number means not only cubes. For example, if you are using a four-digit number, then you need to take four to the power of 4 like that. That means our formula. That means this logic will be applicable for only 3 digits. For example, if you are taking like 153, that means it is a 3-digit number. Okay. So I think Nagini, you are asking one doubt. So and even Pavan also is asking doubt. If you are doing, that means not only 1 cube, 5 cube, 3 cube. This is called, this, you are taking only 3 digit number. Then you have to do like 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. If you would like to do 4 to the power, that means 4 digit value. If you are taking 4 digit value, then you need to take like 1 to the power of 4, 5 to the power of 4, 3 to the power of 4, and something 1 to the power of 4. You have to take 4 digit, then the formula will be changed and logic also will be changed automatically, because it will be applicable for 3 digit number only. Okay. Okay, so Armstrong number means we have basically the concept itself is one is an Armstrong number, because one. Okay, if I am giving like 2, that means if you are having 2 digits, then it is an Armstrong number. Okay, so basically in your interview point of view, many students got the doubt here. Okay, even Virveni is also asking. So yes, Virveni, that's absolutely. But even some website also, they done everything is is displayed as wrong only. Okay, even the good website is there one, I think Geeks for Geeks, you know that. Okay, for max function, for max function he has given some wrong. Okay, actually many websites are giving wrong options. Okay, so but you should understand what is an option number base. Not only cubes, if you are using a 3 digit number it will cubes, if you are using a 4 digit number it should be power 4. Okay, I think you can find that number definitely. Okay, otherwise I will give you, I think 2000 you will get some value. Okay, no. How 351 how 351 is your Armstrong number? No, how? So for example, if you are doing 351 you will get 153. If you are doing 351 you after sum you will get 153. You have, if that means you will get the same number, which whatever the number you have taken after sum of cubes also you have to get the same number. But if you are taking 351 you will get 153. Then how it is a 351 is a Armstrong number? You should understand very carefully. So very, that is also one of the good doubt. So yes, if you have any number please let me know, Monica. Okay, I think Harshita, your doubt cleared. Shall I move to the next question? Harshita, please respond. Yeah, okay, fine, thank you. Okay, I think all doubts are cleared guys. So let me open it guys, because don't follow some websites, because I don't want to tell, actually you don't use like Geeks for Geeks. Geeks for Geeks is one of the good website actually, but it is also showing some because I always used to check more websites. I always used to check more websites when I'm preparing for the class. Okay, so can you please tell me guys, here I'm writing this logic. So this is one of the favorite website for many programmers including me. So can you tell me what is the answer this? No, I not this. 1 minute guys, I would like to tell one more question. Please wait guys, please wait 1 minute. Okay, so please guys, can you please answer this question? Can you please answer this question? What is the answer? Everybody should answer. Everybody, please. I am printing maximum value, right? I am printing maximum value, right? Yes. So many students are giving the answer Geeks. Okay. So let me run it, guys. Let me run it. Okay. Let me run it. Because why I am telling this example, guys? Why I am telling this example, guys? So don't blindly follow one website. Okay. So because I always used to prefer so many web preparing Python classes for itself. Okay. So please, I will run this program. So I'm getting Geeks. Okay. So you can check here. So the output of this program is fur. He is telling that. So this is actually Geeks for Geeks website. This is very famous website actually. Okay, so because if you are preparing like this you cannot understand it. Okay, so that's the reason I'm telling, because if you are studying anything you should, that's the reason I always used to prepare first. So whatever the programs I would like to cover today, I will prepare like this. September 21, September 22, what are the programs I need to execute? Before that only I have to prepare every concept like GCD. Let me, I will move. So Armstrong number. Okay, just now I explained factorial. Okay, so I will practice September 21 only. I will prepare. Okay, so after that only I will execute here only. Okay, so this is the way I am preparing for you guys. Okay, but you are not responding, because why I am telling this? Only 27 students have submitted the assignment last class. So why, I don't know. But I'm checking all the assignments every time. Okay, because. So in only two lines I am asking that whatever the palindrome program, I am just giving what are the four lines, I think these are the lines, just for loop this code was already written yesterday class itself. You just have to send even copy paste also, but we are not doing that. Okay, don't follow the every websites blindly. Okay, so why I am taking this lecture, because in Armstrong number so many websites are giving that every number should be with cube only, that is a Armstrong number. No, that's not at all. Okay, if it is a 2-digit number, it should be power 2. If it is a 3-digit number, it should be power 3. If it is a 4-digit number, it should be power 4. You should think like that. Okay, so the correct answer is geeks only, but in the website it was showing that it is a wrong value, like fur, but it is absolutely wrong actually. Okay, so I think I will move to the next concept. So I have completed Armstrong number, what is an Armstrong number and all. So let me move to the factors of a number. What are the various factors? This is very important, guys. This is a very important program actually. If you understand this program, you can do a lot of programs. Like if I'm asking like GCD, for example, if I will give you an assignment today. So please, guys, at least try to give half an hour time for me every day. Try to give, please. Because so I am spending 4 hours time to prepare the notes and to prepare the to execute the programs and all. But why don't you are taking 15 minutes time or half an hour time for me to submit the assignment? Who will think? So according to the yesterday Armstrong number program, I think the string program, palindrome string program, I have already given the logic to the reverse of the given string. So just copy that paste, that's all. If you are executing, that's very nice. Okay, that's not at all issue. But if you are practicing, then only you will get your doubts. And some students are also asking me doubts. So when you are doing the assignments, okay. So please try to do. Okay. So now I will move to the factors. These questions will ask in the interviews in so many different ways. For example, like GCD. For example, if I am giving a question like, so you have to take a numbers from 20 to 30, which is divisible by 4, and which cannot be divisible by 7. They will ask some questions like that. For example, 20. That means 3 sevens are 21. So which is divisible by 7. That means that number will not be printed in the output screen. You will get some questions like that. Okay, in entry point of view also you will get the same questions. Even C language external examination also they will get you some question like, so find out the factors, like find out the facts of that particular number. They will get a lot of questions like this. So that's the reason I am telling. First of all, you should understand what is a factors first. Okay, so please let me know. So factors in the sense, for example, if I'm giving number six, so what are the various factors of six? Six means, so in which table six will be the output. For example, in first table you will get six, in second table you will get six, 3 2s are 6, and in third table also you will get six, and in sixth table also you will get six, right? So in fifth table you will not get six, right? That means five is not a factor for six. That means you have to calculate what are the factors of a different number. So this is the very easy program, guys. So let me execute it here. And before going to that, I will definitely give you an assignment, today's assignment based on this question only. So listen carefully, guys. So here I'm giving, for example, let me give an example. I'm giving like, so the factors are 1, 5, 25, because 25 will get in one table, fifth table, and 25 table. So these are the various factors of 25. You know that, right? So let me execute it again. If I'm giving 8, 1, 2, 4, 8, okay, you will get a doubt then. So I'm giving 3. The factors are 1 and 3 only. That's all. So how you should decide the values will get like this, okay? So please listen carefully, then you can understand the how. I will give you a question like, find out the factors of a given duration. I will ask in the duration actually, okay? So this is the question to find the factors of a given number. If I am giving 8, I am getting 1, 2, 4, 8. So that means in one table you will get 8, 2 table 4 2s are 8, 4 table 2 4s are 4 2s are 8, and 8 table 8 means 8 ones are 8 only. That's all, right? So let me execute now. And here the first number what you are taking here, it will be stored in num. That means number value is 8. Okay, the factors of num are, the factors of 8 are, and it will be displayed on the output screen. For I in range, I am taking from 1. Why I am taking 1 from 1? Because the factors will be starting from 1 itself. That's the reason I am taking 1. And I am taking num plus 1. Because if I am giving an 8 means, it will take up to 7 only. That's the reason why I am taking num plus 1. So num plus 1 means it, I will range from 1 comma 9. 1 comma 9 means it will check from 1 to 8. It will check from 1 to 8. That's reason only I am taking num plus 1. I think you are already familiar, because already I explained why I am giving num plus 1 in the previous example. Then this is the only single logic, guys. If number modulus I equal to 0, that means if the number is which is divisible by particular I, okay, that means whatever the number you are taking, 8 modulus 1 double equal to 0, that means 8 modulus 1 is 0 only, because 8 ones are 8, right? So that's the reason it is getting 0. Whenever 0 equal to 0, I value will be displayed. That means the first value I will be taken as 1 only, right? I value will be taken as 1 only. So it will take num modulus I means, num is 8. 8 modulus 1. What is the value of 8 modulus 1? 0. 8 modulus 1 value is 0. If I am giving like 1 modulus 8, this is 1. Okay? You should understand the difference, guys. Okay? So because so many operations depends upon floor division and the modulus. Next. It will move after print of I. This means 1 is printed here, guys. Now it will check another for loop. That means another ith condition. That means next iteration is I value taken as 2. I value taken as 2. Then it will take num modulus I. What is the value of num? 8. Is 8 modulus 2 will give 0. Is 8 modulus 2 will give 0. Yes, 4 2s are 8, right? 4 2s are 8. That means remainder is 0 only. Thus, it is true. Then print of I. That means 2 will be printed. Because I value is 2 here. I value is 2 here. Then again, it is incremented to I value to 3. How 3 will be skipped? You can see here, guys. It is no 3 is there in the output, right? You can see here. So, I am checking with number. That is, what is the number here? 8. Is 8 modulus 3 equal to 0? So 8 modulus 3, how it is 0? 2 3s are 6, the remainder is 2. 2 double equal to 0, condition is false. Then print of I will not be executed and 3 will not be printed, and it will iterate to I value iterate to 4. So I value iterate to 4 means it will check for 8 modulus 4 equal to 0 in the next line. Yes, 2 4s are 8, remainder is 0 again, 4 will be printed. In that way, 8 also will be printed, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Skipped, because 8 modulus 5 will give 3, 8 modulus 6 will give 2, 8 modulus 7 will give 1. It is not at all equal to 0. That means any number which is divisible by particular from 1 to the given range, then you should call it as a factor of that particular number which is divisible by 0. That means if you are getting a remainder, this is a very easy logic, guys. Okay. So hope you understand. If you are having any doubts, please mention the chat box. I will move to the next question. Next. Well, still I have so many questions, guys. So let me write a GCD. Actually, GCD logic in C language and Java, we used to write I think 4 or 5, 6 lines. But here it's very easy, guys. So let me write a GCD. So I already completed. We have the factorial function predefined. Like we have GCD function also, right? So let me write here GCD of 12, 8. So please tell me in the chat box, what is the value of GCD of 12, 8? I have already told that what is a GCD. Please don't ask what is GCD, because we have completed all the math module functions. Actually, module functions are in the third unit according to our syllabus. But I have covered already, right? But may all the students have done the correct answer only. So it is. I am not asking the factors. Some students are sending the factors of the numbers. Okay. So the answer, Dilip, that is the wrong answer. The remaining all students are correct answer, 4. So let me run it. I'm getting 4. the call table in 12 table and 8 table, what are the various factors and which is the common factor and which should be great? That is the four only, right? For example, let me write 12. What are the factors of 12? You should write here 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Okay, so 12. Then 8. What are the factors of 8? 1, 2. Just now I told what is meant by factor. You don't ask me how you are writing 1, 2, 3, 4 and all. Okay, 1, 2, 4, and 8. So you should check the common factor. There is no here 8 is the greatest, but there is no 8 in 12. Okay, you can check 4. Here 4 is there, 4 is there. The answer is 4 only. This is the GCD. But here this is a predefined function actually. Okay, but it is not there in C and Java. But I already told you guys. So GCD is the function which is added in Python 3.7. I think if you are using a old version, it will not execute, guys. Okay, when you are using online GDB.com also, it will not execute. Okay, so let me clear it. And if you are using the logic, but that is not a good practice, guys. So you should write a logic. So what we have to write a logic first. Okay, that means for example, if you are taking two numbers, because in the factorial you are taking only one number. Here you have to take two numbers, because if you are giving like any GCD, what is the GCD of 3? That is a meaningless question. If I am giving like what is the GCD of 3, 9, it's a meaningful question. In the same way, you should give two numbers, number 1 and number 2. Then take a variable I equal to 1. This is iterative variable, that's all. Let me take I less than or equal to number 1. So for example, I will tell easy, okay, because we don't have time already. 1 hour completed actually. So time is running very fast, guys. Please wait for a moment. I will take I value as 1. I will take the values like 4 and 6. Okay, 4 and 6. So what is the greatest common GCD? What is the GCD divisor? Tell me. 4 and 6. Yes, guys. Yes. Very good, guys. Very good. So I hope everyone is understanding. The answer is absolutely 2. That's all. Thank you, guys. Let me explain. So now I am taking I value as 1 because I am comparing with the numbers 1 less than or equal to number 1. What is the number 1? Number 1 is 4. And means you have to true both the conditions. Then only the loop will be executed. I less than or equal to 6. That means 1 less than or equal to 6. Both conditions are true. Then you have to apply the logic of factors here. In earlier example, I just wrote like if number modulus I equal to 0. But you have to check for number 1 and number 2. That's all. I have written like if number modulus I double equal to 0 and number 2 modulus double I equal to 0. That means here the first number it will be taken like 4. 4 modulus 1 equal to 0. Yes, 4 modulus 1 equal to 0. It's absolutely true. And 4 modulus 6 modulus 1 equal to 0. Yes, 6 modulus 1 equal to 0 also true. So both are true means GCD equal to I, GCD equal to 1, because only one value is there right now. So now the GCD value is 1 only, I value is 1. Then if condition, after if condition, it will take I equal to I plus 1. Now I iterates to 2. Now I value iterates to 2. Okay, guys. So whenever I value is 2, it will check, it will go back to the while loop. And it will check, now 2 is greater than or equal to 4, 2 is greater than or equal to 6. Yeah, once again it will check either 4 modulus 2 equal to 0 or 6 modulus 2 equal to 0. Yes, 2 2s are 4, 6 3 2s are 6, remainder equal to 0 in both cases. Then GCD equal to I. That means in GCD, earlier we have 1. Now it is replaced with 2. Okay, so let me execute it now. I equal to I plus 1. Now I value will be 3, 3 less than or equal to 4. And 3 less than or equal to 6. Both conditions are true, guys. Then it will execute like if of 4 modulus 3, not at all 0. 4 modulus 3, not at all 0. Okay, 4 modulus 3, which will give 1. Whenever this condition is false, you don't check this condition because here 1 and is there. That means GCD will not be changed to 3. GCD will remain up to 2 only. Okay, this is the way you think. Then only you can understand programming. What is a programming and all. Okay, let me move, guys. I equal I plus 1. Now I will increment it to 3. No. What is already? Okay, I already incremented to 3, guys. So now I incremented to 4. 4 less than or equal to 4 and 6 less than or equal to 6, not 6, 4. 4 less than or equal to 6. So both conditions are true, guys. Both conditions are true. then it will enter into the loop. So number modulus I, that means 4. Okay, what is the number 4 modulus I? What is I value? I value is 4. 4 modulus 4 equal to 0. That is right only, because 4 modulus 4 is 0, right? And number 2 modulus I equal to 0. Number 2 value is 6. I value is 4. How 6 modulus 4 equal to 0? 6 modulus 4 will give the value 2. So it is not at all equal to 0. That means this condition is false. So GCD value will not change. GCD, it remains 2 only. Again, it will link I value incremented to I plus 1. Now I value becomes 5. But here 5 less than or equal to 4, because number 1 value is 4 only. So 5 less than or equal to 4, condition false. Whenever the I loop while condition false, it will return the print statement. GCD of number 1 and number 2 is GCD. Just mean GCD here, GCD is a variable, not the predefined. You can take G also. That's not an issue at all. So now whenever you're giving GCD, GCD is 2. That means you already told that. So 4 and 6 GCD is 2 only, right? So you can clear this. Let me run it, guys, so you can understand easily. So how I am writing this logic, I think you understand after the facts. Okay, that's the reason only I first read the how to find out the factors of a given number. So let me give a number like 4, and let me give a number like 6. I am getting GCD of 4 and 6 is 2. I think hope you understand, guys. Let me move to the another example. Let me pre alt F9, okay, control F9, okay. Let me give a number like 9, and I'm giving like 1. The GCD of both numbers is 1 only. The GCD of 9 and 1 is 1. So this is the GCD example. So don't by heart the logics, guys. So I'm telling easy way only. I'm telling an easy way, and I'm telling only easy examples, because whenever you're searching your Google or websites, any websites, they always use you to write a program using functions. They will always use like if, modulus, num1, num2. They will do in a lot of ways. Okay. Here, once again, I'm telling GCD is not just a variable. You can remove G. You can just put G also. That's not an issue at all. Okay. So don't think it is a predefined, because we have already GCD. That is function. Here it is a variable. You should understand the difference. So let me run it again. I'm giving 6. I'm giving 8. So GCD of 6 and 8 is 2. Because in both the also 2 only the factor. So that is the GCD. So I did not give any conditions. I think the logic is very clear, guys. But the time is already left 5:20. But no students are left today, because I think today topics are very clear to guys. And many students are giving in the feedback form the absolutely fine. Whatever I'm delivering the lectures. Okay. So they are telling in the feedback link, they are absolutely clear, sir. They are telling, we are understanding very clearly how we can write a program like that. Okay. But if you're giving that feedback, so I may not be happy, because you use it to write a logics first. Okay. Because whenever you are understanding the tracing, you can have a idea to write a program. How you can attempt a program, you should definitely know. Because many students are having doubt like, so programming is very tough. I thought that programming is fun. That's all, guys. Okay. I have already shared the feedback link. Actually, I have so many commitments. I have MCET exam currently going on. So please, guys. Actually, I would like to cover a lot of topics till I have a Fibonacci series. I prepared a lot of programs, guys, but I don't have much time. Okay. So anyway, so now the time is 5:21. Shall I take 10 minutes? Okay. Is it okay for you, guys? If you don't have any problem, I will continue. Okay, thank you, guys. Thank you. Okay, no problem then. No problem. So many persons are having some different works. So they are skipping the classes. Even our college management also very interested. So if I don't want to take a class, definitely they will give permission. I am teaching the class regularly because of for you understanding only. Because whenever I'm giving a break of 1 week, so you will forget some concepts. So that's the reason only I'm not giving any single break even. Okay. So because our management people are not giving like, you just do the class every day. They will not tell in like that only. Okay. So hope you understand, guys, please. I will tell you anyway, if you're interested, I will tell you the next program. Fibonacci series. So I always use it to write a logic. I'm just copying the code, right? So before going to that, I would like to give you how we can perform a Fibonacci series program. First, you should understand, even this program is asked in Coghlan interviews also. So first of all, what is Fibonacci number? So Fibonacci series actually. So I will give a Fibonacci series. I will forward the notes every day, guys. But you should practice. If I am doing one program in while loop, you can do in the same in the for loop. You should do some assignments. Okay, if I am giving only one assignment, it's not only sufficient. If you would like to get the more knowledge on programming, you should practice in different ways. If I am doing any program in using for loop, then you should do that program in for loop, while loop. So you just think in that way. Okay. So okay, fine, guys. And many students are giving the answer. Tejasvi. So very good. That is absolutely right. So the first number is always taken like 0, and next number is 1. Many students don't know about Fibonacci series. Even the faculty is also there, right? So let me explain what is a Fibonacci series. Fibonacci series means if you're giving the first number and second number should be 0 and 1. This is called F1. The second number is called F2. Add these two numbers, you will get the third number. That means 0 plus 1 is 1. And the next number is 2. Next number is 3. Next number is 5. Next number is 8. How I am getting this? Oh, wait. So this means F1, this is F2. If you want to get the F3 number, you have to add the first two numbers. 0 plus 1, 1. Then if you would like to find out this number, you have to add the two numbers before the number. That means not 0. Okay. That means 1 plus 1, 2. Then if you would like to know about the next number, 1 plus 2, 3. Okay. Once again, I am telling you, you get 1. So if you want to next digit, you have to add these two numbers. That means 1 plus 1 is 2. If you want the next number, you have to add these two. That means 2 plus 1, that is 3. If you want to add the next, if you want the next digit as a Fibonacci series, you have to add these two numbers. Then you will get 5. And add these two numbers and you will get 8. And after that, you can add these numbers. You will get 13. After that, you can add these two numbers. You will get 21. That's all. And you can, series will be continue up to end. So I think Robo movie you have all seen, right? That is depends on programming. And whenever the Robo is introducing by Rajnikanth, okay? So some fellows are sitting at the function hall. They are asking the questions like questions are there, okay? In that question, if you see that movie, one person will stand up like he will give one number. Is it a Fibonacci number? He will ask like that. And then Robo will answer like, yes, it is a 27th Fibonacci number. How we can tell a 27th Fibonacci number if you add these lines? So, but Robo will tell like that, okay, but we cannot like this. But Robo can be developed by programmers only, you should understand, right? Okay, so next. So, how should I write this program? You should take two values, F1, F2, that's all. Okay, take 0, take 1. And take F3 and 0 plus 1. That means F1 plus F2 you have to add. That's all. This is the logic only. F1 plus F2 you have to. But after that, you should take the recent values. That means F1 equal to F2 or F2 equal to sum. So you have to take two values like this. Because after that, whenever you're changing 0 plus 1, you are getting 1. Then you are moving to the second digit. Like, let me write like this. 0, 1, 1, 2, 3 like this. Okay. I'm writing like this. Okay. If I'm taking these two numbers, then after that addition, you have to take these two numbers. That means when I take this sum, you have to forward this value to F2 and F2 value will be transferred to F1. That's all. This is the only logic, right? So you just think in that way, definitely we'll get programming, right? So let me move. Clear the console. One guess. No. So let me run it, guys. So I'm giving 10. The series will print 10 terms. 10 means series will print up to 10 terms. So you can check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is the Fibonacci series of up to 10 terms. Okay. So hope you understand, guys. So here I am taking only n value as integer. That means input of enter the value of n. Morning only. Sorry, guys. Okay. So please listen. Here just I am taking Now I'm making 25. It is getting 46,368. So, but Robo is telling even 25, around after 25 also. But if you are doing like this, we cannot do like, because we are right, just writing a program. But compared to Robo, we are only best, right? Because we are doing the programming, right? So anyway, guys, let me explain. I will explain up to 5 terms. It will skip number 4. How it will skip, you can easily know. Oh no, I think it is 5 only, right? Let me use 6. Okay, so it skips 4. How you are getting 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5? So let me run it. So I will do the tracing. N equal to int of enter the value of n. That means enter the value of n, n is I am taking 6. That means you can take n value as 6. F1 equal to 0. Why I am taking F1 0, F2 equal to 1? Because you can, if you are telling even numbers 2, 4, 8, you should use 2. If I am asking like that, what will happen? In the same way, the series will start from 0 and the next number is called 1. That's the reason I am taking F1 equal to 0 and F2 equal to 1. That's all. Okay. That's not a part of logic actually, because I'm just basic understanding only, okay? And some students may differ like F1 equal to 0, F2 equal to 0, F1 equal to 1, F2 equal to 0. They will bypass the program in that way. So you don't think like that, okay? Because this is programming, okay? If you bypass the program, you should understand only then that particular time itself. After that, you get the job, but what you do, okay? So you should don't think in that way, blind guys, please. Whenever I'm taking 0 and 1, why I'm taking 0 and 1? Because the first number is 0 and the second number is 1. It should be defined by Fibonacci series itself. That's the reason I'm taking 0 and 1. And sum equal to 0. That means sum, I'm assigning a variable like 0, because sum is like a third variable. That is called, when I am getting 1 here, this sum is stored in 1 here. So now sum equal to 0, count equal to 1. Count means I'm taking how many times I have to iterate the loop. So I'm taking a variable, it should be started from 1. Because if I'm giving 6, it will print it 6 times. You can check. That's the reason only I'm taking a variable called count. So Fibonacci series, it will space only, you can remove that, that's not an issue. Just I'm giving for this, just for giving the space of first value, okay? It is just giving a space, it's not required actually, you can give Fibonacci series, that's also, that's not an issue at all. And while counter less than or equal to n, I'm declaring 1. That means you can check this logic first, 1 less than or equal to, n value is 6. The condition is true now, guys. It will enter into the loop. Then print sum. What is the sum value? Sum value is 0. That means first 0 printed. I am crossing the 0. It is printed over. Okay. So now it will add it. That means first number is printed. Then this is the only logic. These two lines mainly. F1 equal to F2. Here you have to like F1 equal to. What is the value of F2? F2 value is 1. You should write in this way. Some students are like F1 value is 0. F2 value is 1. 0 equal to 1. What will happen? They will find like this. If you are finding in this way, you will never get programming. Please don't do. It is just a variable. You have to assign the right side value to left side. Every time you should do in this way. So F1 equal to F2. F2 is nothing but the 1 will be stored in F1. Why I am doing this? Because whenever you are adding 0, 1, 1, 2 like this. Okay. So if you are getting the third number, if you are getting the third number, you are skipping this digit and you are adding these two numbers for getting the next number. That's the reason only I am taking this logic F1 equal to F2 and F2 equal to sum. That means sum value is stored in F2 equal to sum now. So whenever I am assigning F1 equal to 1 and F2 equal to sum, the old values will be deleted. That means sum value is 0. Now F2 equal to 0. Okay. F2 equal to 0. Next. Sum equal to F1 plus F2. That means F1 value is 1 and F2 value is 0. Now sum contains 1 plus 0. 1 plus 0 means sum equal to, I am writing here, sum equal to 1. I am writing here, 1 minute guys, sum equal to 1. Okay. Sum equal to 1 means the old value 0 will be removed from the memory. Okay. And F1 equal to 1 in the sense the old value 0 also will be removed. And F2 equal to 0 means it will delete the old memory. Okay. So next. Let me continue. Next. After that, count equal to count plus 1. This is for iterating the value. That means count equal to 1 means, here count equal to count plus 1 means count earlier it is taking like 1 only. Now it will iterate to 2. Then it will go to the while condition. That means now it will check instead of 1 less than or equal to, it will check 2 less than or equal to, because count incremented to 2. 2 less than or equal to 6 means you have to print the second number. That means you have to print this number. So how we will get it, I will tell you. So 2 less than or equal to n. That means 2 less than or equal to 6 condition is true now. It will enter into the loop. F1 equal to F2. What is the value of F2? F2 value is 0. That means F1 will be stored as 0 only. That means old value will be deleted. Okay. Next. F2 equal to sum. F2 equal to sum. What is the value of sum? Sum value is 1. Sum value is 1 means F2 value will be 1 now. Okay. F2 value is 1 now. Next. Sum equal to F1 plus F2. That means sum equal to F1 is 0, F1, F2 is 1. 0 plus 1, 1. Plus 1 means 10 to 3. Again, it will check the loop 3 less than or equal to 6 or not. 3 less than or equal to 6 is condition true. Okay, then it will print sum. It will print sum. So earlier you missed that s equal to whenever s equal to 1 means it will print it again, right? We forget it actually. Okay, yes, whenever s equal to 1, whenever it is encoded into the loop, the sum will be printed first, right? That means whenever 2 less than or equal to 6, 1 is also printed, right? So we have to cross this. After that, s value is 1 here, 3 less than or equal to 6 condition. 3 less than or equal to 6 condition. Okay, so sum will be printed like 1, because sum is stored in 1, that means third value also printed 1. Then it will enter into the F1 equal to F2, F2 equal to sum. What is the F2 value? F2 value is 1. Then F1 value will be replaced with 1. Next, F2 equal to sum. Don't confuse, guys. Please don't confuse. Just practice after completion of the class, then only you can understand. F2 equal to sum. So for example, in earlier, we are having sum value as 1. Then it this value will be stored in F2. So then this one will be removed and sum value will be stored in F2. That means sum value will be stored in 1. That means now it is entered into the sum. Sum equal to F1 plus F2. F1 value is 1, F2 value is 1. 1 plus 1 is sum value is 2 now. That means sum equal to 2 now. And count equal to count plus 1. Count will be 4 less than or equal to 6. Condition is true now. Okay. So then sum value will be printed. What is the sum value? Sum value is 2. So 2 also will be printed. Okay. So then, so F1 equal to F2. Okay, F1 equal to F2 means F2 value is 1. So this value will be skipped to F1. That means now F1 contains 1. F2 equal to sum. Sum contains 2. Now F2 contains 2. So sum equal to F1 plus F2. F1 means 1. F2 value is 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. Then sum contains 3. Then count equal to count plus 1. Now count increment to 5 less than or equal to 6 condition is true. And it will check F1 equal to F2. That means F2 value is stored like 2. This will be stored. And sum equal to F1 plus F2. F1 is 2, F2 equal to 3. 3 plus 2 plus 3 is 5. Okay. So the sum is contains now 5. Next. Count equal to count plus 1. Count value incremented to 6. Earlier it is 5. 6 less than or equal to 6. Condition true now. It will enter into the loop. Sum value will be printed. What is the sum value? Sum value is 5. It will be printed. Okay. That means all the statements are printed. But till loop will execute. Okay. Because F1 equal to F2. F3 equal to F3. F2 equal to sum. Sum equal to also done. Count equal to count plus 1. So count value will be 7. 7 less than or equal to 6 condition false. That's the reason. It will skip to the from the while loop. Then already we got the all the values like 0 to 5. Right. So this is the way to find out the Fibonacci series. Okay. If I am giving the question like this, you can do the same program. Write a program to check whether the given number is a Fibonacci number or not. You can do in that way. If I'm telling the logic here in this way, you can do in that way. Okay. If you want to practice program, that's all, guys. Okay. So once again, I am forwarding the feedback link. If you have any doubts, I will be here. So please let me know. If you don't have any questions, you can leave. Okay, thanks. Any doubts? Please let me know. Any doubts? If you're having no doubts, range. If you're using for loop, you can do. No problem. That's not a problem at all. Okay? So, processor. Range function, you cannot do in this way. Because range function works upon for loop, right? Next. Any more questions? No, sir. Clear. Okay. Fine. Thank you. So please copy the link. I will end the class then. Nobody is asking. Okay. Likhita, clear. Okay. Fine. Thank you, Likhita. I think your doubt cleared yesterday. Doubt. Fine. If you have still any doubts, you can mention in the chat box or in the feedback link. Okay. Yeah, you can do, no problem. Up to range only it will print, but it will not work for this. Okay, so no. LCM is different actually. Logic, a complete different kana. Okay, so if you want that logic, I will tell you. That's not an issue at all. GCD should be called as like thing HCF, not LCM, because LCM is least common multiplier, right? So you should be, the logic is different. Yes, you are telling LCM, but HCF is same. Highest common factor and GCD are both are same. No problem. Yes. You can do same. But your question wrong. That's the reason only I'm asking. Okay. And processor, no. It cannot be possible from quantity that here, because if you're giving the range, how it will print here, it will add the two numbers, right? So here range function will not work for this program. A to B equal to delta sum. Okay. That means you want different. You want me to write a LCM program tomorrow? What Likhita? What's your doubt? If anybody would like to speak with me, you can speak. No, that's not an issue. You can mention in the chat box. I will give you an option to speak with me. No, Lasya, it's not possible. It's not possible, Lasya. Because there is no increment operator here, it will automatically increment it. Okay? So, okay. Good question, Lasya. But you can just give an example. Okay? If you nothing like that, if you're giving like for I in range of 0, 0, you just put like that. Or if for I in range of 0, 1, you may not get any output, because it will, whenever you're taking like 0, it will not take any number. Okay, in the first number itself. Good doubts. Okay, anyway, I think now the time is 5:40. So I'm sitting exam up to only 6 o'clock. I have to move. Thank you, guys. Thank you, all of you. I think everyone is safe. Stay home, stay safe. Okay. Please use masks. Okay. So, bye bye. Take care. GCD to for loop. Yes, change. No problem. You can do in different ways, guys. Okay. Whatever the program I'm telling, you can use in a different loop and you can do the program in different way. And what's your doubt? Some student written like this CA4 Harshita from second CSE. Oh, it's a name, but too long. Harshita, it is getting very long program, I think so. Because whenever you are using your Armstrong number, I already told that I'm telling in an easy way, right? Okay. Yes, that's also fine. That's also fine, Saranya. That's absolutely correct. That's not an issue. But it will take two numbers. Okay, two. Well, okay, that's good. It's absolutely similar to our logic, right? Okay. But I think many students are practicing. Okay, you can use this time in a very good manner, because you may not get sufficient time in future. Because if COVID ends, you may not get even public holidays like Pongal and all. Okay. I think you cannot expect any holidays in 2021. So we may say we may face a lot of problems without holiday, because if you are usually working in still 6 days within a week also, even though we are not having any holidays, we will also face some problems, right? So you can use this holidays period. So you can learn programming. Programming is not a very big thing. It's a very basic point. If you understand only some addition or some multiplications, you can do a lot of programs. You can do a lot of programs. Okay, guys. Shall I end the session? Nobody is asking questions. Thank you, guys. Stay home. Stay safe. Bye-bye. Okay.